Hello, welcome, welcome, and indeed thrice welcome to the first of a new audio release. I'm sorry I haven't a clue live. John Naismith here, mystery voice and producer of the programme since 1991. The idea behind this I'm sorry I haven't a clue live series is to present something more akin to the experience of being an audience member at a recording. The result are shows that are considerably less edited than the 28-minute versions heard on the radio, and they're complete with the occasional fluff and pre- and post-show banter from the panel. Each live recording features two editions of I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue. We have digital technology to thank for the availability of the material. When I first took over the show, the recordings were made only on quarter-inch analogue tape. I then cut down the single master tape, and everything I cut went, quite literally, into the bin. When digital arrived for us in 1994, I dubbed the digital tape of the recording onto a computer hard disk prior to editing, which meant that the complete tapes of the recordings remained uncut. It's these tapes that have provided us with the recordings you're about to hear. This first live double recording of I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue was made on the 11th of November 1995. It features Graeme Garden, Barry Cryer, Willie Rushton, and making his debut on the show, Jeremy Hardy, taking the place of Tim Brooke-Taylor, who must have had better paid work on that day. During my time producing the show, I've been quite strict about ensuring that the regulars have all managed to make each recording, so it's quite rare to be without a regular team member, and every previous commercial tape or CD of the show featuring Willie Rushton has only featured the existing regulars. The result is that the bulk of this recording has never been previously released. However, there are other reasons why it retains a special place in my memory. We were used to recording a show in the Paris studio in Lower Regent Street in front of 300 people. This was an audience of 1,300, our biggest yet, and the recording takes place amidst the splendour of Harrogate's beautiful Royal Hall, built in 1903 by the unrivalled theatre designer Frank Matcham. Previously, our audiences would cheer Humph's announcement of the round Mornington Crescent. This was the first show that the audience cheered several of the other rounds. I even hear myself on the recording saying it felt like the Rocky Horror Show. And, of course, it was the first time that Jeremy Hardy's unique singing voice was launched on an unsuspecting public. 1995 was a particularly good year for the programme. After 23 years on the air, it suddenly started to win prizes, picking up both the Sony Gold Award for comedy and a British Comedy Award within the space of a few months. 1995 doesn't seem that long ago, but it might be useful to remind ourselves of the lie of the cultural and political landscape. On television you could see Noel's House Party, Challenge Annika, Gladiators, Play Your Cards Right, Pets Win Prizes, and Film 95 presented by Barry Norman. Iain McCaskill and Michael Fish were still forecasting the weather. The National Lottery was in its infancy. Nick Leeson was famous for bringing down the UK's oldest investment bank. Barbara Cartland for being the UK's oldest-looking novelist, Judith Chalmers for looking orange, and Geoffrey Archer for being dishonest and the author of several novels. We could still remember when Snickers bars were called marathons, and most topically of all, Yorkshire Water, already reeling from fat cat and leaky pipe accusations, had imposed yet another drought order. We join the panel on stage, just after I've asked them to test their buzzers, prior to the recording of the first programme. We were using a buzzer system last employed for a recording of just a minute, and to Humph's obvious delight, it transpired that someone had forgotten to remove the names of the Just a Minute panellists.
Who do you want first, then?
Says Derek.
Derek? fair enough. I'm Derek.
Maria?
What show was that?
Please.
Maria, do your buzzer.
Yeah, that's all right. Clement?
Not really, it's pissing down outside.
And Paul. So that's your... Anyway, they all work. Can I test mine?
Sorry, could you hear it at the back?
Can't hear Barry Cryer!
Oh, lucky people. I get him all the time. He'll tell you about his back in a moment if you can hear him.
OK, David, when you're ready with the signature tune, let's go.
We present I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue, the antidote to panel games. At the piano is Colin Sell, and your chairman is Humphrey Lyttelton.
Hello and welcome to I'm Sorry I Haven't a Clue. You join us this week in the splendid town of Harrogate in Yorkshire, where I read that as early as the 16th century, William Slingsby discovered a local spa. Visitors to the town through four centuries have been amazed by the health-giving properties of the water here. Today, of course, visitors are amazed to find that Harrogate Spa is the only source of water of any description in Yorkshire. And it was on a visit to Harrogate in 1926 that Agatha Christie went missing, a mystery that remains unexplained to this day. There is, however, the occasional experiment conducted by a dedicated group who endeavour to recreate some traumatic event liable to cause complete disappearance from the public eye. Before they start, let me introduce them to you. They are, on my left, Barry Cryer and Graeme Garden. And on my right, Willie Rushton and Jeremy Hardy. And finally, a lady ever willing to oblige when the teams are keen to score, the lovely Samantha. OK, our first round is called Miss Tits. Is that the Queen? Patrons of the performance arts will know that nothing sells better than a good title. In idle moments, I've often pondered what the magic formula might be that makes a smash hit from a title that might otherwise be a bit of a turkey. Well, writing the words Andrew Lloyd Webber underneath certainly seems to help. Teams, I'd like you please to suggest some titles of films, shows, songs or other entertainments likely to have been surefire flops. Graeme, will you start, please?
When Harry Met Janet Street Porter.
No, what? Jeremy, sorry.
Seven Dwarfs for Seven Samurai.
Barry.
Death in Venice.
Willie.
Sleepless in Sheffield.
Right, this time round you can all do it in any order you like. In fact, like the last time round.
Tales of the Expected.
Give my regards to Broadmoor.
Natural Born Grocers.
Big Knobs and Broomsticks.
Look back in Ongar.
A remake of Marathon Man called Snickers Man.
Fantasy foot powder.
Gonorrhea with the wind.
That's too close to home, that.
Cattle on a hot tin roof.
Bring me the bed of Alfredo Garcia.
It's now time for a game called One Song to the Tune of Another, which if it didn't exist, no one would have heard of. It's a sobering thought. In this round, teams, I'd like you please to... I wish they wouldn't put I'd like you to on this bloody script. I have to read it with a voice vibrant with sincerity. It's harder every week. In this round, teams, I'd like you please to sing the words of one well-known song of my choosing and attempt to fit them to the tune of another. You'll be accompanied on the piano by Colin Sell.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.